controversy, I believe, is a massive understatement. In fact, based on previous research papers, peer-reviewed papers, that number is probably at least an additional 1.5 C above that 0.4 C. So I don't think it's taking into account the myriad factors that change when we lose Arctic sea ice. For example, all the loss of albedo that will be experienced when you change from white ice, very reflective ice, to the dark blue surface of the ocean that follows. That's a tremendous change in albedo. Suddenly, all that energy that was going into melting ice is now going into heating the ocean. And I can't imagine that alone won't contribute more than 0.4. And in fact, I found a peer-reviewed article that indicates it will contribute much more than that. And then we also have to take into account the loss of the collapse of industrial civilization, almost certain to result from that rapid rise in global average temperature. That adds another degree or two or more. We don't know exactly because we haven't collapsed industrial civilization just yet. But we know that as little as a 20% decline in industrial activity leads to a 1°C global average temperature rise. So that's enough to do us off, and therefore loss of all life on Earth. So I think this recent paper greatly understates the situation, which is exactly what I've come to expect from peer-reviewed literature. So that should come as no particular surprise. Remember that it was the IPCC, I believe in October of 2018, maybe 2019, concluding that climate change is irreversible because of overheating of the oceans. So we're going to overheat the oceans some more. Climate change is already irreversible, according to one of the more conservative bodies, scientific bodies in the history of the planet, the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change. So I really believe that the loss of Arctic ice is going to do a lot more than add 0.4°C, even if we do maintain the set of living arrangements, because of albedo, heating of the ocean, warming of nearby land, on and on, the list goes. So I think that's a classic understatement from the peer-reviewed literature. And at what point do we trigger a human extinction? I suspect we're already there. It was the European, I don't remember the name of the paper anymore, but there's a wonderful synthetic work put together by this European body. I've cited it many times in my written work, indicating that 1.5 degrees above the 1750 baseline is enough to trigger human extinction. And we're well above 1.5°C above the 1750 baseline. The paper, which dates to 2018, I think, let's say 2018 plus or minus a year, indicates that we were only at 1. So there's all this shifting of the baseline going on. I see it every day. People indicating that we're at 1°C above the 1750 baseline. We're clearly not. We're clearly at 2°C above the 1750 baseline. Anybody who's